Papa Ted here, and today I'm going to be reviewing The Binding of Isaac Rebirth, which has just been released on PSN Store. So basically, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth is a remake of the original Binding of Isaac, which was developed by Nicolise and designed by Edmund McMillan, also of Super Meat Boy fame. So what is Binding of Isaac if you've never played it before? Well, basically it's a top-down 2D roguelike dungeon crawler in which you control Isaac or one of the other characters that you can unlock and explore procedurally generated dungeons and basically battle different enemies and find different items to progress through the game and get to the final boss at the end. So basically, you, like I said, it was randomly generated levels, and as you progress, you're fighting different enemies in each room, and along the way you basically can collect money or find or buy equipment from shopkeepers, or find keys to get through to special treasure rooms, find new weapons, power-ups to strengthen Isaac, which give you a better chance against the upcoming bosses that are on each floor. Now, I absolutely love me a roguelite game with randomly generated levels, and I did have the original Binding of Isaac, so I easily got into this one, and I found the controls on the PS4 fine. You use the left stick to move and the right stick to shoot Isaac's tears. So what's new about the PS4 version, you might ask? Well, this is a remake, so it has all the original content of Binding of Isaac, but it also has all of the Wrath of the Lamb, sorry, expansion pack, which was released on the for the original. Plus, it's got new enemies, new levels, and new bosses, plus more endings. Something else you'll probably have noticed if you've played the original is that the graphics style has been tweaked slightly to a 16-bit, and this is due to McMillan's distaste of the old style graphics. And although they haven't changed much, I personally probably preferred the older style. They were cleaner, and actually I found even on the big screen, the 32-inch monitor, I found the 16-bit style meant that some of the writing was a wee bit more difficult to read. And I know this is intentional, but I don't think either graphic style really detracts from the gameplay at all. One thing I'll say about this game is that it's pretty fucked up. It might look a bit cutesy, but it's dark and there's a lot of religious kind of referencing to do with angels and the seven deadly sins and things like that, and it's very twisted and quite violent actually. So some people might not like the style of it, although I have quite a dark sense of humour, so I like the cute characters, but the gore and things like that. So there's not really much else to say about Binding of Isaac Rebirth, really, and it's quite a simple game, but extremely addictive, and if you like roguelikes or 16-bit dungeon crawlers, then you'll adore this, because this is one of the best. The only other thing really to say is that there is a co-op mode, but it's couch co-op. There is no online co-op, which I thought could have done with. I have a couple of friends that are really into Binding of Isaac, and I would have loved to been able to play online with them and try and get to the end of the levels. So yes, I would fully recommend Binding of Isaac Rebirth for the PS4. It's free right now on PSN, so there's no excuse not to get it and at least try it. If you've played it before and you didn't like this one compared to the original, then maybe let me know why in the comments below. Thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.